I'm going to show you how to add auditorial cues and sound effects to your TTRPGs, all using one tool, the Donner Starrypad. Adding ambient sounds, music, and sound effects is an incredible way to immerse your players into the world that you're building at your table. But fumbling with your phone and trying to switch songs on something like Spotify, or navigating away from your GM notes and using a service like BattleBards, completely breaks the flow of your story and the concentration of your players. This leads to a lot less enthusiastic roleplay and a table full of players who are checking their TikToks while you're trying to tell a story. Want to figure out how to solve this? No need to roll for investigation. I'm going to show you how to do it step by step with the Donner Starrypad. Before we dive into the tutorial, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and ring that notification bell. To get started, simply go to Amazon and search for the Donner Starrypad. You'll find this tool from anywhere from $75 to $100, and it's well worth the price. If you want to support the channel, you can purchase it through the link in the description. Next, you're going to need your digital audio workspace, and this is going to be Reaper.fm. Head on over and click on the Download Reaper button in the top left. Pick your appropriate system. For me, it's going to be Mac OS. Now, Reaper is going to be free for your first 60 to 90 days. I can't remember which one it was. After that, you'll need to pay $60 one time to own the program. Once Reaper is downloaded, all you have to do is wait for Daddy Bezos to send you your Starrypad. And once it arrives, it's time to unbox. Unboxing the Starrypad is actually pretty nice. Once you get into the box, you'll find that it has all the cables you need, and the Starrypad is wrapped up really nice in a protective layer. For a tool that costs under $100, I was blown away by the build of the Starrypad. This thing is great and it feels wonderful in the hand. The buttons are super responsive and the knobs click when you turn them. Let's take a look at all the wires that are going to come. The first one that we'll take a look at is the MIDI to 3/4 inch jack wire. You typically will not need to use this unless you have a MIDI board already. For most tabletop RPG games, the USB-C to USB connection will be totally sufficient. Donner does throw in a USB to USB-C adapter, which I thought was really nice because my MacBook only has USB-C inputs. On the back of the Starrypad, you'll see one USB input. Plug your wire into that and then directly into an adapter or right into your computer. Once the Starrypad gets power, it does this really cool lighting pattern on the buttons, and this is how you can tell that it's plugged in correctly. You'll want to get to know the knob bank, fader bank, pad bank buttons, as well as all 16 of the pads to the right of the board, both faders above the bank buttons, and both knobs above the faders. The rest of the buttons are kind of obsolete for this tutorial. Right now, if you hit the pad buttons, they will all glow the same color as the pad bank button. You'll notice all of the bank buttons have a red, green, and blue setting. Now, hitting the pad buttons, the light will glow the same color as the pad bank button. This will be important later. Now, let's set up your Reaper program. The first thing you're going to want to do is open up Reaper and head to the preferences. Click on MIDI devices and then you'll see the Starrypad. Double click there and check both of these boxes. Once you're done, hit OK and then go to Starrypad again and click all four of these boxes as well. Hit OK and then apply. Once you're done there, double click on the panel to the left to add a track. Then click on the FX button. Once the FX window opens, search for sample and select Rhea Samplematic 5000. Click the Add button and then you'll see this window open. From here, you'll simply select your sound effect track and drag and drop it into the black window. You'll see the wave bar come up. Now you'll need to go back to your track and hit the record button. Then select your input as MIDI, Starrypad, and all channels. Now click on the pad you want to associate that sound with and double click on the note start knob. This will assign that sound to that pad. Now clicking the pad will play the associated sound. To add more sound effects, simply click copy and paste under the same channel and add as many sound effects as you want and add their corresponding pads. But now it gets interesting because I'm going to add a track that has multiple takes of a female screaming. However, simply linking this sound with a pad would not fit my purposes because every time I hit the pad, you would hear all six of the screams in that audio file. And playing it would cause something like this. You get the idea. To select only a portion of an audio clip, go to the beginning of the waveform and drag it to the beginning of the portion of the audio clip that you want, and likewise the end. Now let's talk about ambient noise. When I'm looking for a track for my ambient noise, what I'm looking for is loopability, how seamlessly it will start over again and keep rolling, and two, time. I always try to find tracks that are over an hour long because I never really know how long my players are going to be inside of a room or inside of a location. Now, for today's example, I've got two ambient tracks. One is a police station, and you can hear the police station kind of has cop car sirens. It's got like this low hum. Occasionally there is phones that ring and jail cells opening and closing, that sort of thing. That is obviously going to be for the police station. The other ambient sound that I found is this really cool thunderstorm with a crackling fireplace. I'm going to be using that for an office. However, you can use that one for almost anything. I'll make another video about how I found my ambient sounds, but right now I'm going to show you how to add them into your board. We're going to start by adding a new track, going back into FX and re-adding Samplematic 5000. Now go into your file folder and drag and drop your ambient sound into the black box. You'll see the waveform appear, confirming that it's been loaded. From here, you can mess with volume and play around with things. I like to tend to have my ambient sounds a lot louder because we're going to put them on the fader. But first, let's assign a pad bank button. I like to put all of my ambient sounds in the blue setting so that they don't get mixed up with any of the sound effects. Next, in the top right, click UI and make sure that you click on the volume fader. Once that's done, click Param and go down to Learn. When this box opens, simply move your fader. After you do this, you'll see the name of your fader pop up in the MIDI OSC Learn box. Now go ahead and confirm. Now the digital fader will move when you move your physical fader. Now you can add as many of these ambient sounds to the pads as you would like under this same track. However, do not overlap the pads that you assign with the sound effect pads because doing that will play both of the sounds at the same time. This is a big reason why I move all of my ambient noise and music over to the blue setting and not the red setting, because I know if I'm in the red setting, which is the default setting, I'm only playing the sound effects, which I'm going to be toggling on and off a lot more than I am going to be with ambient sounds. Now it's important to note also with the setting changes, you can change the same settings for the fader bank and the knob bank as well. For this example, I've got two ambient sounds and then two music tracks. What I do is I keep all of those on the blue pads, but I change the fader to green for the music. Likewise, you can do this with the knobs as well. Any variation of colors will just change which ones are currently active. You can assign anything that you would like. Now, let's talk about some special settings with music and ambient noises. The first thing you're going to want to do is down at the bottom of the settings, let's go and click loop. This is going to make sure that when the track ends, you don't have to hit the fader bank again for it to start over. Okay, now let's talk about active voices. By default, your active voices are going to be set to 8. That means that if I hit the gunshot button, I can layer that 8 times on top of itself. And it will continue to echo the previous time that I hit it. You don't want that with ambient sounds and with music, because then you can accidentally bump it and it will play that same track on top of itself at a different point in time. A good example is the mystery noise. I can layer that 8 times, but I can't think of an example where I would want to do something like that. That's just a lot of noise unnecessarily. So let's limit the active voices to 1. Next, I'm going to show you one of the nicest parts of the Donner, Starrypad, and the Reaper combo. If I navigate over to my DM notes or my Keeper notes, I can actively be in a completely separate screen without Reaper actively up, and it still responds. I don't need to have Reaper as my main screen in order for it to work. This allows me to keep my eyes on my notes, so I always know what's going on, and the sound effects don't actually draw my attention away. Against all odds, you've survived this tutorial, and now you know how to incorporate incredible sound effects, ambient sounds, and music into your live TTRPG games. I'm Mo, and this is Eldritch Tabletop. If you like Call of Cthulhu, D&D, and TTRPG content, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to ring that notification bell, and I can't wait to see you till the next video.